Hi everyone, Bria here from Etched Actuarial, and today I'm going to be giving you 5 things that you can add to your study strategy to make it way more effective. So I know a lot of you are in school full-time or you're working full-time and you're trying to fit studying in around those hours. And that can be really, really tough because you have so much other stuff to do and studying just takes up a lot of time too. So I know that you want to be doing your studying as efficiently as possible. So if you include these 5 things in your study strategy, they're going to really, really, really help you increase how much you can actually get done in the amount of time you have. So you essentially don't need as much time. Okay, so let's get into it. Okay, number 1 is picking good study materials. So a lot of people end up wasting a lot of money and a lot of time because they pick study materials that aren't right for them right at the beginning. So it's really important to look at your options and determine what option works best for you in your specific situation. I've actually written a blog post on the best study manual for exam P and FM. I'll link to those in the description of this video and you should definitely check those out. But the one that's best for you is going to depend on your budget. It's going to depend on how much of the syllabus you already have an understanding of and whether you've been exposed to the topics on the exam already. It's also going to depend on your learning style. So some people prefer to read a study manual. Other people prefer to learn from an instructor that's teaching them through a slideshow presentation. So depending on what you prefer, you're probably going to pick different study materials. Now, if you're a complete beginner and haven't really had much exposure to the topics on the exam at all, you're probably going to be best off going with a video course because those tend to be easier to understand for most people. Just a little side note. Okay, the number 2 thing that you need is an overall plan. And this is like your studying roadmap. You need to know what you're going to be doing throughout your entire study period. So you need to make a plan of everything. So most people choose to start with just going through the study manual, which is a really good place to start. But maybe you want to start with some reviews, so you need to have some time for that. And then once you're through your study materials, then what are you going to do? It's really important to have all this planned in advance because this helps you budget your time wisely. Later on, I'm going to recommend that you create a study schedule, and you're going to need to know all the different pieces of studying that you need to get done so that you can budget your time wisely. Usually, I recommend spending about 1 month going through your study manual for the first time, but depending on when you want to write your exam, maybe that's not feasible for you. Maybe you have to get it done in 2 weeks. So you need to have a very good idea of everything that you need to do so that you can appropriately divide that among all the days in your study period. And another reason why I think it's really good to do this is because it can help you prepare in advance. Sometimes you're going to wish you had something later on, or you're going to need something later on that you could be creating early on. So what I'm thinking in this situation specifically is a formula sheet. So sometimes people want to have a formula sheet for later, and a great time to create that formula sheet is when you're going through your study manual for the first time. So if you know that you're going to want that later on, it's really a good idea to know that in advance because then you can plan and you can do that while you're going through your study materials for the first time. So that's why I think it's really good to just have an overall general idea of all the things that you need to get done throughout your study period so that you can have an effective study plan. Okay, on to number 3. And like I talked about earlier, this is a study schedule. Number 3 is a study schedule. A lot of people underestimate the importance of a study schedule, and it's actually really, really, really important, so do not underestimate it. What I recommend you do is take your roadmap that you created from earlier, the number 2 idea that I shared in this video, take that and split everything that you need to do into daily tasks. If you're a member of my study strategy program, you actually get a daily goals calendar. And with that calendar, I've broken out the whole roadmap that I've planned for you into very specific tasks that you need to complete each day. So you can do the same thing for yourself. Once you know your roadmap, break it all up so that you have about 2 or 3 hours of studying each day, or maybe you can only fit in 1 hour of studying each day, but fit it into equal chunks of tasks each day so that you are able to keep consistent with your studying and you don't have to end up cramming on weekends. One of the things a lot of people do when they don't have a study schedule is they cram. And cramming is a really, really, really inefficient way to learn. It's better if you can learn a little bit every day rather than learning a huge amount on the weekend and trying to remember all that. You'll be able to remember things a lot better if you can just learn a bit every single day. So we are talking about efficiency in this video, and that's a big, big tip. And actually, on my website, I have sample study schedules that you can use to help design your own. I'll leave links in the description below, but really these are just sample schedules. Everyone's going to be a little bit different, but you can kind of base your schedule around these. So they have time to go through study manual, they have time for practice questions and practice exams, but you're going to have to adjust that based on your own strengths and weaknesses as you go through. But that can just give you a general idea of what this looks like. And actually, on the website, it's just weekly, so you'd also have to break that out into daily goals if you choose to do it that way. I think it's a good idea to do that. Okay, number four, almost there. Number four is accountability. So for those of you that don't know, accountability is really just having someone there to keep you going, keep you pushing forward and motivated to keep studying. So a really great way to do this is to find a study buddy or a study group, or you can join the study strategy program where I'll keep you accountable to your study schedule. But if you have someone there that's always like, hey, remember this is important, you want to pass your exam, so keep studying, well, that will help keep you motivated and pushing forward. When you're really busy, it's easy to procrastinate. It's easy to let other things take priority over your studying, even though that's not what you really want. So if you have an accountability partner, someone there just to keep you on your toes, well, that will make a world of difference for you because you'll get things done that you probably wouldn't have otherwise gotten done. I'm sure there's lots of times in your life where you can think of things that you intended to do, maybe New Year's goals or something like that. Well, if you had an accountability partner, I'm sure that there'd be a way better chance of you actually completing your goals than if you didn't. So keep that in mind. Try to find a study group or a friend that's writing the same exam as you would be great. Okay, the last number five thing that you need is someone to answer all your questions or a place to go to get your questions answered. We're talking about efficiency here, and I know you want to be as efficient as possible while you're studying. You don't want to waste time. So you're going to have questions that are going to take up so much of your time to try to figure out by yourself that it's just going to be a huge waste of time. So what I recommend is you find someone, like a forum where you can ask questions. There's Reddit or the Actuarial Outpost. Or maybe your study materials have an online forum where you can ask questions. If you're in the study strategy program, I'm here to answer your questions. But just find someone that can answer your questions so that you don't have to waste time trying to figure them out yourself. If you've started studying and have done any of the practice problems, you probably know that the solutions are not very clear. A lot of the time they skip over steps and kind of just assume that you know what they're doing. But that's usually not the case. Even I have a hard time trying to figure out what they're doing sometimes because they just make their solutions so difficult. So find someone that can help you along the way so that you don't have to waste time trying to figure it out. Someone like me in the study strategy program is always available to answer your questions so that you can be as efficient as possible while you're studying. Oh, and one more note on that is, if you're not understanding a question, I never want you to just skip it. A lot of people skip things that they don't understand, and that means they're skipping important things. And you can't just skip over things that you don't understand because that means that you're not going to be able to get those questions right on exam day. Never ever just skip over something because you don't understand it. I know it takes a lot of time to try to figure it out yourself. If that's the method you choose to do, like, you can sit there and try to figure it out yourself. That's one way to figure things out. But if you want to have the most efficient, time-efficient study strategy, then it's going to be better to find someone that can help you with that. Okay, so that's all five things. Now, I know I've talked a bit about the study strategy program in this video, and I just wanted to let you know that in the study strategy program, which is where I help people writing exam P and FM to know exactly what they need to do step by step along the way during their study period to give them the best chance of passing. But the study strategy program includes all five of these aspects. It includes a study schedule, it includes accountability, it includes me to answer all your questions, it includes a roadmap. I create that for you because I've been through this process so many times with myself and with others that I know what you need to do. And it includes me helping you pick your study materials so you don't make a bad decision in that area. So if you're interested in joining that, I'll leave a link in the description below. I'd love to work with you. And yeah, so that's the end of this video. I hope you liked it. Give it a thumbs up. And if you do not want to miss any other videos like this, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out. See you in the next one. Bye!